toys, tools, DIY projects. There are countless applications where small battery packs are needed. If original replacement battery isn't available, or if one just wants to use some spare cells to save some money, DIY battery pack is a great solution. Recently I've had multiple devices that would benefit from having a new battery, and they all have input voltage in range of 2S lithium pack. 2S means 2 cells in series, and in such battery pack voltage is about 6 volts when empty to 8.4 volts when full. Lithium cells have many good aspects, but one needs to take really good care when using them. Voltage shouldn't rise above certain level, and same goes for discharging them. There's a safe limit which shouldn't be crossed. Charger usually handles the charging state safely, but the discharging is left for the device or board inside the battery pack. I designed a simple protection circuit mainly to be used with 18650-based DIY battery packs. The PCBs were ordered from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who provides PCBs for prototyping and low-volume production, with prices starting from $5 plus shipping for up to 10 100x100mm PCBs. If you need a different sized board, more than 2 layers, or any other specific feature, that's not a problem either. You can upload your files and fill in your required features to check current pricing on their website. For all your prototype PCB and PCBA needs, check out PCBWay.com. I designed my protection circuit around HY2120 IC made by Hycon. With 2 external MOSFETs and couple of resistors, it handles voltage and current monitoring during both charging and discharging. The small on-state resistance of the MOSFETs is used as a shunt for current measurements. That's why it's important to study the datasheets of different MOSFETs when picking which one to use with this IC. This circuit should cut out the output when the voltage on either of the cells drops below a certain level. Also, if the device is trying to pull too much current, this should shut off the output until the short is removed. There are different variations of this chip, including different voltage limits and different behaviors when those limits have been crossed. I decided to use one that requires plugging in the charger when over-discharge protection has kicked in. You can see the specs of different variations in the datasheet. Link is in the description. The schematic is the one from the datasheet. I didn't find need to add anything, at least for the first test version. The final circuit on the board seems quite simple and small. It's actually just quarter of the size of this PCB. There's a reason for this PCB being much bigger than the active part of the circuit. Electrically, this circuit would work just as well even if it was this small. I designed this PCB to sit on top of 2 side-by-side 18650 cells like this. Connecting short nickel strips from ends of the cells to this PCB will connect the cells in series and make a nice solid battery pack. In my opinion, this looks like a nice, clean battery pack. Some heat shrink tubing or a hard case, and it's a perfect battery for many applications. That is, if it works. Left multimeter measures the voltage coming from the cells to the board. Right multimeter measures the voltage from the output. What would happen if I was to short the leads on the output side? This board should detect overcurrent or short circuit and thus turn off the output, and the input voltage should stay more or less unchanged. That is exactly what is happening. When I disconnect the short, output returns back to normal. So if the device is malfunctioning and trying to draw too much current, this protection board will kick in. Another very important thing is the over-discharge protection. Device that originally used some other battery types or batteries that had protection board in them might not have any kind of low voltage cutoff features in the device itself. If that is the case, such device could ruin new lithium batteries by discharging them too low. To test this protection, I will connect a load to the output and wait for the battery to drain. The protection should kick in when the voltage of either one of the cells drops down to 3 volts. And again, that is more or less exactly what is happening. Now I am confident that I can use the battery packs made with this protection board without worrying too much about accidentally draining the cells too low.